To begin with this first lesson, I will explain to you the use of music writing and why it is the simplest and easiest way to understand music. To begin with, we have the audible range, which is represented by this line. The human ear can hear the section that corresponds to the frequencies between 20 and 20,000 Hz. The piano has an output that is approximately between 35 and 3,500 Hz. To the left, we have the bass pitch. The sounds that we can't hear are called infrasounds. Only some mammals are able to hear these frequencies. And to the right, these are the ultrasounds, which are heard by dogs. What concerns us is the piano's spectrum, which is the piano's register. In this section, there's an infinite number of sounds, just like on a mathematical line, that represents the numbers between 35 and 3,500. We have split up the line in 88 equal parts, where each part corresponds to a sound, which is also a note on the piano. There are 88 notes, and consequently, 88 keys on the piano. It would have been possible to create a keyboard formed entirely of white keys. However, as you may have noticed on the drawing, this would not have been helpful to locate notes visually. This is why we have built a keyboard that has black and white keys arranged in this way. You must notice that the order of these black and white keys are always the same. Two black keys, a gap. Three black keys, another gap. Two black keys, and etc. Only the white keys have names. In fact, Western music, dating back to the Middle Ages, originates essentially from monks who, with their Gregorian singing, gave these keys codes. And during this era, the seventh number was the perfect number. So, there are only seven keys that have a name C, D, E, F, G, A, and B. The black keys are used to find the sharps and the flats of these partitions. However, we will see this in more detail in future lessons. The white key to the left of the two black keys, C, is then followed by D, E, F, G, A, and B. And then we repeat C, D, E. When the white and black keys are combined in this way by 2 and 3, it becomes very easy to visualize the notes. And to be able to play a key in a fraction of a second with our fingers to produce a sound. In order to well visualize and understand the keyboard, a few hours is all that is needed. What we need to do now is know which key to play and in what way to get there. This is where the famous solfeggio scale comes in, which always seems daunting to many beginners. Firstly, you must not think that the scale and music scripture was invented quickly. It took many decades for the Gregorian monks and musicians of the Middle Ages to write music in its simplest form. Some methods are still tried now, which seem easier at the beginning, like writing the name under the notes, or using colours, or even just trying to memorize the left and right hand separately on the keyboard. In practice, though, all these methods are actually more complex and difficult to understand, and often lead to a standstill. To understand musical scripture well, you must go back to the keyboard. This keyboard represents a scale if we turn it sideways. The general idea is to write the notes on the scale to understand very quickly which key you must play on the keyboard. Remember, only the white keys are associated with a note. There are 52 white keys on a piano keyboard. On this drawing, there is only a small section of the keyboard, but it is possible to imagine placing a note on each space which corresponds to a key. Just like how we use lines and spaces, with 26 lines we can represent a keyboard. Here is the middle C of the keyboard on these 26 lines. Note that it is impossible to recognize different notes from an area of just lines. The idea is good, however, it must be simplified. The only way to do this is by using less lines. By knowing that we only exceptionally use the extreme ends of the keyboard, it becomes clear that there is no need for as many lines. 80% of the notes you will play can be placed on 11 lines. To come back to middle C, we now have only 11 lines out of the 26 there were before. However, reading 11 lines is still not easy. Our eyes haven't got the time to differentiate the exact number of lines. The best idea was to remove the line for the middle C, which gives us this. So we find ourselves with 5 lines above and below. These 5 lines are actually called a range. We can now write middle C with a little line through it, which is the line that was removed. The upper range corresponds to the right hand, and the lower range corresponds to the left hand. To never get confused, we will use clefs. On the piano, we have the bass clef and the treble clef. The bass clef is used for the lower range, and the treble clef is used for the upper range. And for practical reasons, we will separate the two ranges, and middle C is written exactly the same in the lower range of the treble clef, or in the upper range of the bass clef, just like you can see on the diagram. To remind you, C, which is the middle C of the keyboard, is written on the line that we had removed, which is the same note which we can see in the bass clef or in the treble clef. From this middle C, we can locate the other notes within the range of the treble clef, which gives us C, D, E, F, G, A, B, and again C. And in the bass clef, we have C, B, A, G, F, E, D, C. Here we have a piano keyboard. You can see the black keys separated in groups of 2, 3, 2, 3, etc. The C that we have talked about is here in the center of the keyboard. To locate the C, it is to the left of the lock, which is above the keyboard on a grand piano and below on a vertical piano. In the introduction, I have recorded 2 pieces that you would be able to play within 6 to 9 months of playing the piano. Nearly all the notes are played in this section, which corresponds to the 11 lines that we spoke about earlier. For example, Bach's Prelude. For example, Mozart's Sonata, and the last example is the Italian Concerto by Johann Sebastian Bach, which is no longer a beginner's piece, but advanced. Now, we will read music notes. The solfeggio is essentially based upon the reading of the treble and bass clefs simultaneously. This is the main difficulty for beginners. You must always read the notes from the bottom to the top, because we will always be thinking from left to right whilst we are playing. A level that is required for professionals is to read 4 notes per second in both treble and bass clefs simultaneously. This means we must work very progressively and not do any difficult exercises at the beginning. I propose that in this first series of 25 lessons, a reading technique that is progressive, which will allow you to easily understand the partition and allow you to also decipher both hands at the same time within simple divisions. In this first lesson, we will only read C and G in both the treble and bass clefs. You must first start with the bass clef and then the treble clef. Always read aloud the notes and don't change the exercise before you have mastered the one you are currently doing. C, C, G, G, C, G, C, C, G, G. G, C, C, G, C, C, G, G, C, G, G, C, C, G, C, G, 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 C, 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 G, C, G, G, C, G, G, C, C, G, G, C, C, G, G. We will now repeat this solfeggio exercise a little bit quicker. C, C, G, G, C, G, C, C, G, 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 C, C, G, C, C, G, G, C, G, G, C, C, G, C, G, 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 C, 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 G, C, G, G, C, G, G, C, C, G, G, C, C, G, G. Now for the instrumental part. In front of you, the part of the keyboard which is the center, the C that is to the left of the two black keys, which is a white key, also known as the middle C. You place your right hand with your thumb on the middle C, and we will play C. The key to the right is played with the index finger and is D. Above D is played with the middle finger and is E. Then with the ring finger we have F. And to finish with we have G, played by the pinky. When playing piano, we don't use the name of our fingers, but numbers. The thumb corresponds to number 1, index is number 2, middle finger is number 3, ring finger is number 4, and the pinky is number 5. The same for the left hand in the same direction. The thumb 1, so in this direction 1, 2, 3, 4, and the pinky 5. You place your right hand on C with the thumb. And we play C. Whilst keeping the key down right up until the next note, D, you let go of C when you have played D. So the principle is that we keep the note down right up until the next note is played, like E, where we take the finger off D. And then we switch to F, G, F, E, D, C, C. For now, we will only be using the white keys. Later, we will play on the black keys. But for now, only the white keys are being used. We will start again with the thumb on C, D. Be very careful with the position of your thumb, which should always be above the keyboard, and never beside it. Many beginners have the tendency to have the thumb here whilst playing another note. So always keep the thumb above the keyboard. F. By rotating the wrist a little bit, you can keep the thumb above the keyboard. G. And we go back down. F. E. D. C. It is very important to work very slowly. When you press the key, your finger must stay pressed down on the key for you to hear the note. Play like this is not practical. For now, a slow speed is what really counts. C. D. Even if you think you can go faster, do not go faster. E. F. G. F. E. D. C. So, that is the right hand. You can practice for a while to make it perfect, and once it is perfect, we will start playing the left hand. So, take your left hand and place the pinky on the C. Within the octave, the left hand is going to be placed to the left of the right hand, with the pinky on C. You have the two black keys, and C is here. D. We go up E, but it is the opposite for the fingers. F with the second finger. G with the thumb. We come back down. F. Always hold down the keys. E. And keep in mind of your thumb positioning. D. C. D. E. F. G. F. E. D. C. The speed at which you work at is very important. Later on, you will be playing pieces much faster. At a professional level, we play at nearly 24 notes per second. It's with the slow working pace that we will make progress. So we carry on very slowly. C. D. E. F. G. F. E. D, C, it is very important to well connect the notes. I will show you with the right hand. I will play C with the thumb. You hold down the C all the way, right up until you play D. And when you play D, the thumb must let go at that exact moment, just like that. You keep the key down, just as you are about to prepare for E, which I am showing you with my third finger. So I'm going to play E, and I will let go of D at the same time. And we call this legato. So we must always play fluidly in all the exercises that I will provide you. The opposite of legato is detached, also known as staccato. I will show you what this is. Staccato is very short. Each note is played at a fraction of a second, just like as if the keyboard was steaming hot. This is a second technique of playing the keys, which we will see later on. For now, we will play legato. You have now been able to play with the left and right hand separately. Now we will play them together. The left hand in the same place with the pinky, the right hand with the thumb on the middle C. You have the two fingers ready to play at the same time. Now you prepare your left hand, and remember to prepare your left hand, then your right hand, but you don't press any keys until your fingers are ready. When ready, you play them at the same time. So you hold the keys down, and now you prepare E with your left and then your right hand, and then press them both down at the same time. The same for F and G, and we go back down. F, E, D, C. So remember to do these exercises regularly. Start by working your right hand until it becomes instinctive, and then the same for your left hand. And then you practice doing them C, D, E, F, G with both hands, always in the same direction, C, D, E, F, G, G, F, E, D, C. We have arrived at the end of your first lesson. Concerning the first solfeggio exercise, you must be able to read it without hesitation. Therefore, I advise you to practice daily. To work well, at minimum 10 minutes of practice each day is needed, and you must be able to play very slowly. The technique to playing the classical piano is based upon the length of which you practice. It's by working slowly and repetitively that you will attain a virtuous piece of work. The most important thing is, at the moment, is for you to understand the notes. Do not change lesson until you are able to comprehend the notes perfectly.